Hey guys, this is Eric Tarr for theproaudiophiles.com. This is my second video of a two-part series on using Kontakt with one-shot samples and loops. In this video, I'll be demonstrating how you can use a sampler like Kontakt to create your own virtual instruments that trigger a loop that's going to synchronize with the tempo of your song. Here I'm going to be working with some drum loops from the company called I Want That Sound. These guys have put together some awesome collections of drum samples and loops. I highly recommend you check them out and stop by their website. I'm going to be working with their organic library, specifically the pre-recorded loops. So I can drill down in this folder here. They've included some Rex loops. If you're someone that likes to work with Propellerhead's Reason, they've got the Rex loops in there. And they've also got the more general purpose, just audio files, the WAV files right here. And that's what I'm going to be working with. So let me demonstrate how you can create a virtual instrument that can have multiple loops spread out across the MIDI keyboard that will synchronize with the tempo of your song. For instance, let's say I want to work with these loops right here, the linear hi-hat. I'm going to go ahead, grab this one here, loop one, just drag it into Kontakt like this. All right, you'll see at the bottom, it's spread out across the keyboard. So I can even trigger it. Important thing to note going initially is that this loop was recorded with a beats per minute, a tempo of 78. So when I play that middle C right here, it's going to play the loop at the original tempo. But if I play a different note, what's going to happen is it'll trigger it at a different tempo and also at a different pitch. All right, and that's pretty good. That might be something you want to work with and get creative and try it out with different tempos and try it out with different pitches as well. But if what you would like to do is keep it at the original pitch and just synchronize it with the tempo of your song, let me show you what you need to do to set that up. So I'm going to click on this tool here. It's going to open up all these options for me to parameters to adjust and to control the loop with. So to begin with, one of the first things that I usually do is with a loop, look at the release settings. Because if I hold this key down and then let it go, the actual instrument within Kontakt is going to keep the loop going. So if I stretch this out, compress the key down, when I let the key go, the loop is going to keep going. So usually when it comes to a loop, what you want to do is actually just whenever the key is no longer pressed, you just want it to stop. So I'll just shorten the release all the way down. All right, so that's working great. Next up, you have this tracking button here. The tracking is the thing that's controlling whether it's going to get pitch down or up. So right now with tracking on, if you turn tracking off, I can play different keys. Still the same pitch and also the same tempo. For now, this is fine. We'll come back to this later on. So next thing to go in is look at the WAV editor. This is how you can control things. For instance, chopping up your loop and detecting the different samples so that they can synchronize with the tempo of your song. So what I'm going to do here is turn on the sample loop right here. We're just going to click one. You'll see that it's going to go over the entire loop right like this. And it says this is the end and this is the start. Now you can adjust these things to wherever you want in the loop. I'm going to leave it for the full loop like this. One thing that you'll note though is that if I turn the loop off, like this, what happens is it plays all the way through the end and then it just stops. If you turn the loop on, then it'll repeat over and over. So I'll just demonstrate this quickly. So the loop ended. If I turn this one on now, it'll get to the end and just repeat over. That's because I've got it set until end right here. You have a couple other options whether you want to play it forward and backward and so on. And with a loop like this, typically when I'm working with it inside of Kontakt, what I like to do is have the loop on so that it can repeat over and over. I don't have to worry about triggering it every time I want it to start. But that's just up to you to figure out how you like to work with it. Next up, let's look at some of these other tabs. For instance, I think it's a good idea to go in and set the beat machine right here. The beat machine is going to allow you to do is grab the different transients and synchronize with the tempo of the song. You can also do this more manually. For instance, if you go onto grid, you can turn this on and off like this. Beat Machine requires that the grid is on. So it automatically detected that the original tempo was 78 BPM. If you need to set this manually, you can do so. And it seemed like it did a pretty good job of picking up where the beats are. Now, it all depends on the drummer, how well the drummer played to the original grid in the click. Now, you might have a loop where the drummer adds in his own kind of feel, where there's some kind of swing to it, where you don't want to just automatically chop it up on every single 16th note like this. You might want to go in and switch it over to auto. Now, what auto is going to do is, doesn't matter where the actual grid is, what it's going to do is allow you to just find the beats like this, pick those up, and use those. You have to be careful though, sometimes there might be some transients that are missing, that didn't detect them for whatever reason. What you can do is actually go in and manually, like this, if I zoom in, here's one that didn't get picked up. You can zoom in like this, find my missing hit right here. Zoom in to the one. I can add an extra one right here to the start right there. Now I've got my manual one that's set. You can even lock that in place. Okay, zoom back out. I've got my beat how I like it. Next thing, I can go over to this sync and slice. What that's going to do is make sure that my tempo now is synced to the tempo of my song. So right now, within Kontakt, it's 120 beats per minute. If I turn this beat machine on like this, it's going to keep those manual edits that I did to the grid, or you can switch it back over and do the one where it just chops up every perfect 16th note and so on. Whatever you like to use. So now if I trigger it, you'll hear that it's going to go at 120 beats per minute. The difference is it didn't pitch shift it up. It kept it at the same pitch. Whereas before, when I was using the tracking mode, what would happen is if I moved it up, if I played a higher note, it would speed up the tempo, but it also turn up the pitch or make the pitch higher. So this allows me now to trigger the different notes across the keyboard. If I turn tracking back on with Beat Machine on, now it's going to keep the tempo the same, but allow me to pitch shift it. And if you want, you can even see here, if I turn off the synchronization with my DAW, that was 120 beats per minute. The Beat Machine can just synchronize with Kontakt, its own tempo. Turn it back on. So now, no matter what tempo is inside of my DAW, I can have these loops, even if they are recorded at different tempos, automatically synchronize. Let's say for instance then, I want to add in another loop. Rather than just have a single loop spread across the keyboard, let me go back here. If you switch on the mapping editor, what it allows you to do is precisely pinpoint what keys are going to trigger this loop rather than spread it across the whole keyboard. So let's go in here. If I zoom in a little bit, I can see, let's say I just want it around this octave. Like this. Now I have a single octave. You can change the root key as well if you want it to be higher. That way, you can pitch it down or up. It's up to you to do that kind of stuff. Let me add in a different loop then. Go back here to the Finder. Let's grab loop 3, for instance. Drag and drop it in. Let me spread it about across the keyboard for a full octave too, like this. All right, so I've got one loop here and the other loop here. I can even go in now that I've got loop 3 selected, do things like make sure that it's turned on, it's looping, and it's also going to synchronize with the Beat Machine. I can turn on auto if I want, leave it on fixed. Let me trigger the different loops now. Here's loop 1. Loop 3. So those loops are pretty similar in performance. They have slight variations between how the drums were hit and so on. But you can do this with all kinds of different loops. They don't have to be, you know, the same exact thing. I could go in here, grab another loop from a different one. How about the boom clack? Let's drag this one in. Spread it out across the keyboard. It's recorded even at a different tempo, like this. It automatically, just for this loop, detected 72 beats per minute. Make sure the loop is on. Trigger them side by side. And that's all there is to it, guys. This is how you create a virtual instrument that can have multiple loops spread out across the MIDI keyboard that can synchronize with the tempo of your song. If you got questions or comments about this, feel free to post them below and I'll make sure to get back to them. If you want to see, in a different video, how you can create a virtual instrument that's more built around triggering one-shot samples of multiple velocity levels, make sure to check out my first video in this series on how to do that. Till next time, take care, guys.